coming for this talk, right? We are happy to welcome Professor Chada here to give us a talk on Habitat and Transportation 2020. All right, shall we start the talk now? All right, please.
Thank you very much. Can you hear me behind?
Yes.
My name is Professor Chada. I'm born in India and I've been teaching for the last 30 years. I've been educated at Harvard University, Stanford University, and London Business School. And it's my job to try and make each one of you feel different today. I want you all to feel different. This is my job. I want to open doors and windows in your mind to try and look at things differently. So even though this is a lecture, I want you all to sit back, relax, and enjoy. It's very important for each one of you to try and relate and understand as to what I'm trying to do here. To do that, I want to go down to the basics of what's happening in this room.
Right?
It's an abstract thing that exists in us, but that is where we feel and examine the thought process, whether it's coming from the heart emotionally, or it's coming from the brain intelligently, or it's coming from the soul spiritually, and make them more adaptable to what human beings require in the future. This is the fundamental of how you approach the word design. Do you agree with it? Does it make sense? Rational sense? Okay. Now, thinking of design and being students of design, I'd like to ask you very simply, what are the two things that influence you the most in your life? After you wake up?
Emotion.
Okay. Anything else?
Surroundings.
Now, if you look at these pictures, this picture is in Santorini, in Greece. That one is in Norway. This one is in Eastern Europe, in Ukraine. And this one is in the Far East. I forget where. They have just a mountain. They live in these surroundings. And they have a beautiful lakeside. They live in these surroundings. Most plants and animals are specially adapted to survive in a particular habitat. Not the orchids of your country, survive in this kind of environment. If you pick them up and you take them to Africa and put them in a desert in Africa, in the Sahara Desert, they cannot survive those plants. So this balance is very important between animals, plants, and it has a great impact on human beings. Keeping that in mind, why am I telling you all this in terms of design and how does it work in design? That's what we're getting to. Today our habitat is very dependent on international grid of energy and water. We're buying and selling water between countries, we're buying and selling power and electricity between countries. Energy crisis, clean water shortage, global warming and environmental pollutions are worldwide problems. It helps you to go from one place to another place. Transportation is the movement of people and goods from one location to another. This was the old way they used to take wood in Australia. And this was the first flight in 1903. Airships to aircrafts and now to the space shuttle. Even in horse transportation, for example, you can see how it has slowly evolved based on our needs. From the time when we started, right in the beginning, to the pink Cadillac, to the modern sports car. Bicycles. How we started and where we are on simple things of transportation. And this has been used for 25% of the aircraft instead of aluminum. This helped to reduce the overall weight by 15 tons, thus reducing fuel consumption and noise. Engine noise has also been reduced by zero splice inlets integrated into the engines, which is a single piece instead of several pieces glued together. What I'm going to show you is that you already live in an era where the cars are more intelligent. They talk to you, that the door is open, the light is open, that you're traveling too fast. It tells you through parking sensors how to park your car. It tells you much more information than 20 years ago. Please have a look at this video.
Intelligent too. When chips cost a penny, the roads will have chips in them, sensing the presence of cars. We'll have hundreds, thousands of millions.
And transportation are the two most important things that are influencing you at all times. The rain has probably stopped. So you'll have to change your way of thinking how you want to get to your next place. It happens in environment. Understanding how important plants, animals, and human beings are, and how they are interrelated, and one relies on the other. And then bringing the basic concept of how you think, and where the mind is, and conditioning your mind to design, keep an environment in mind, and then coming with a product design that meets your client's requirements. Any questions from anyone? Did you all like it?
Yes.
Thank you very much.
Do you have any questions?
Yeah.
Just ask you a question.
Yeah.
Consider yourself a better designer or a better businessman?
Me? I'm not a businessman, I'm a professor.
You
have a business
school?
Am I a business
school?
Yes, I went to business school. And then finally I decided that common sense is the most important out of all senses. And that's why I'm here trying to explain it to everyone. Keep it simple in design. Keep it something that is easily accessible. Look, everyone in this room. Three most important companies in the world, McDonald's, Pepsi, Marlboro cigarettes, which I shouldn't be saying, but I'll still say it as a brand. All selling products of almost a dollar. Making billions out of a dollar. How did they do that? Is it a design? What is it that makes it work? Design plays a role in us being able to achieve our goals and our success. Thank you very much.